The characteristic of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the believer, he never gets tired from the book of Allah. And the gems and the amazing treasure in the book of Allah, they never come to an end, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was once describing the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same for the stories of the Quran. The more you read the Quran, the more you see the same stories, the more you is revealed to you a different perspective in our life and in the society of today. And if you look at the story of the Fir'aun against Musa alayhi salam, there's a lot of amazing things that are happening in our life today. But we don't have much time to just reflect on one aspect. The aspect of the magician of Fir'aun. There is something in every one of us. There is part that is really what motivates every one of us, and this is the nature of a human being, is the balance between the fear and safety. Fear and safety. Someone, he fears to be hurt, then he looking forward to be always in a place of safety to secure himself. Someone, he's scared from poverty. In the other hand, he's secure and to say be in a place of safety that he will not be touched by poverty. And this is balance who motivate a person in his life. Because if someone holding on something that is keep him secure and safe, that he will not go to fall, the thing that he need to hold on, for the people, non-believer, need to be something tangible. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about in the Quran about Iblis, how he will get people to submit to him. قَالَ الشَّيْطَانُ يَعِدُكُمُ الْفَقْرَ وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ. The shaitan is threatening you poverty. So someone is like seeing poverty in every vision. If every in his dream he see he's scared by poverty, and he's seeing poverty, so he wants to secure himself. وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ. He didn't say he ordained to you the fact to protect yourself from poverty. He's pushing you to go beyond the limit. If you see, for example, someone, he wants to store a food for 1 week. He said, how much you want to eat, for example? He said, 10 pounds, for example, of rice. He said, let's get 30 pounds. After 1 week, you only going to eat 10 pounds. Why those 20 pounds, that 20 pounds to help him to sleep soundly? Because when he go to sleep, he feel like fully secured, he has the 10 pounds plus. And that plus, that what have a reflect into the system of being for someone to be greedy and to be always hasting and craving to accumulate more and more. And this is the nature in the human being. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want the believer to have this security, this safety to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, you don't see the rope of Allah, but the strongest rope is the rope of Allah. That's why the bridge of the unseen to hold on the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you feel secured, that is the great iman, that is the true iman. The magician of Fir'aun, they have the same thing that I was talking about. It's a conflict about safety and fear in the system. When Fir'aun called them, look what they said, وَجَاءَ السَّحَرَةُ فِرْعَوْنَ قَالُوا أَإِنَّ لَنَا لَأَجْرًا إِنَّ لَنَا لَأَجْرًا. In Surah Al-Shu'ara, أَإِنَّ لَنَا لَأَجْرًا is more confirmation. Are we going to have a reward? They fear Fir'aun, they want to be close to Fir'aun, they feel safe. So how safe? If you're going to win, are you going to reward us? Look Fir'aun what he said, defeated and he's scared and he doesn't want to show it. قَالَ وَإِنَّكُمْ لَمِنَ الْمُقَرَبِينَ. Not only you're going to have reward, but you're going to be one of the closest to me. That's the safety. That's the safety, and they feel like secure. Now, when Musa alayhi salam, he doesn't have any army around him. He was by himself and Harun. But Musa alayhi salam, his face is a face of a truthful. of Sadiqun, when he speaks the truth. He, عليه السلام, threatened them, what he told them, قَالَ وَيْحَكُمْ لَا تَفْتَرُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا فَيُسْحِتَكُمْ بِعَذَابٍ. He said, be careful. Don't force any lie against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If not, he's going to cast you into the doom of the hellfire. Subhanallah, here you have a conflict. The fear from the fire coming from the wrath of Allah, or fear from the power of Fir'aun. Now, the fear from Fir'aun, he's going to be rewarded by safety and money and being close to the emperor. But the fear from the God of Musa is not yet sure. You see, this is how we live in our life. How much fear we have from Allah, that's what helps you to be closer and you run to Allah. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ, flee to Allah. Now, when they gather together, they will be speaking and concealing their speech. They said, this is Fir'aun, we're going to be like one of the most famous people. فَأَجْمِعُوا كَيْدَكُمْ ثُمَّ أَتُصَفَّى. Let's go, we're going to be, you are the greatest today, you are the highest. These are only two magicians, they are weak. Maybe Musa, he learned some speech, strong speech that he scared them, but it's not gonna work. Now, when it came, look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-A'raf that we were reciting, قَالُوا يَا مُوسَى. Look, he's like threatening. And imagine Fir'aun on his throne and sitting, and all the minister and all the army, and we have these two weak, Musa and Harun. But they are the strongest. Why? Because Allah is with them. Who knows that they are the strongest? It's only the believer. And this is, subhanAllah, what now we see in our society. The criteria of evaluating things people are done with their own eyes. But they don't know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He had the power over all things. وَالْقَالُوا يَا مُوسَى إِمَّا أَن تُلْقِي أَوْ إِمَّا أَوْ أَن نَكُونَ أَوَّلْ مَنْ نَلْقِي different آيات. قَالَ أَلْقُوا. Musa عليه السلام, he said, throw. Now when they throw, Musa عليه السلام, as we said it before, and Allah mentioned in the Quran, قَالُوا فَأَلْقَوْا سَحَرُوا أَعْيُنَ النَّاسِ وَاسْتَرْهَبُوهُمْ. They put illusion in the eyes of the people. وَاسْتَرْهَبُوهُمْ. What it means, تَرْهَبُوهُمْ? They put terror and fear in their heart. That's what we're talking about. So the people watching, the fear in their heart is going to, like the balance is going to wear, to submit to Fir'aun. And the magician, I'll have, you know, fun, and this is their winning. But when Musa alayhi salam, by the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, qala alqi ma fi yameenika ya Musa, through what you have, now is Allah's power is going to work, ya akhwan. And this is what we need in our life. When you trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the stick of Musa to turn into snake, that's the power of Allah, is not the power of a magic. And the power of Allah is with every believer. Every believer who trusts in Allah, the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with him. The power of Allah is with you when you make sujood, is with you when you are fasting, is with you when you're reading the Quran, is with you when you show piety and you do righteous in your life. That's the stick of Musa, is everyone has the stick of Musa, which is his piety in his heart. When he threw it, and it said in the narration that the chief of the magician was blind, he told them, describe for me. They said, they could not speak, they were mesmerized. He said, describe for me. He said, he's eating our sticks and our robes. He said, he's eating? He said, yes. Then they described to him, it's the flesh. It's not an illusion. Then they combine the threat of Musa, the fear of Allah, and they realize that the real safety is not with Fir'aun, is with Allah. Because the power of Allah is greater than the power of Fir'aun. And the doom of Allah, well, subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa adhabuh, is greater than the adhab of Fir'aun. And the safety with Allah is greater than the safety offered by Fir'aun. What they did? They jump into sujood to enter in the gate of the rahmah of Allah. You remember he said the sujood in the gate to the paradise, to the pleasure of Allah? That's what they did. فَأُلْقِيَ السَّحَرَةُ سُجَّدًا وَأُلْقِيَ السَّحَرَةُ سَاجِدِينَ قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. We believe in the God of the words, the God of Musa wa Harun, the God of Musa wa Harun. And that's one of the secrets that happened in the heart of the magician, that we want to bring it today in Ramadan to implement it in our life. يقول سبحانه وتعالى in حديث قدسي. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said in حديث قدسي, قال من اعتصم بي من عباد, whoever from my servant he hold on me, he attached, he trust in me. فكادت له السماوات والأرض وما فيهن جعلت له من بينهن مخرجا وفرجا. Whoever who hold on Allah and the whole heaven and the earth and whatever in it they plot against you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save you and give you a way out from it. That's man i'tasama billah. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us real example that we read in the Quran in Ramadan to learn, to teach ourselves, to teach our children, to call for it in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can every one of us have the power of the stick of Musa, which is the piety to hold on Allah? Because when you are in sujood, you get the greatest of the greatest of the thing, the ma'iyya of Allah, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be with you. اللهم ارزقنا معيتك يا أرحم الراحمين وارزقنا اللهم النور في أبصارنا والتقوى في قلوبنا يا رب العالمين وإلى الصلاة يرحمكم الله.